A very hearty evening to one and all present over here. I am Saurabh Singh Jariyal, and I welcome you all in the fourth session of Orange City Literature Fest Season 2 by SGR Knowledge Foundation and radio partner Big FM on 29th November 2020. It's the fourth session of this hall, and the session will be of 40 minutes. So we will now be discussing with Meeta Kapoor on the journey, tradition, and culture of Indian food. Ma'am is the founder and CEO of Pyahi, India's leading literary consultancy. Her first book, The F Word, is a food book, memoir, and travelogue. She has edited Chili's and The Project, Writing Food, an anthology on essays on food. A freelance journalist, she writes regularly for different newspapers and magazines on social and development issues, along with travel, food, and lifestyle. She has received many awards, including the Femina Superwoman Achiever Award 2018 at the World HRD Congress, the Maharani Gayatri Devi Award for Women of Excellence 2014, and the Karam Veer Puraskar 2009 for her work as a journalist in creating social awareness and for being the best literary consultant in the country. She curated Masala Chops, a food court in street food in Jaipur in 2018, and was a member of the Executive Council for Jawahar Kala Kendra from November 2016 to October 2018. She is also the producer for the Women Up Summit and Soul Connect Experiences, and was the producer for Mountain Eco, the Bhutan Festival of Art, Literature and Culture 2010-2019. Ma'am is currently the literary director for the JCB Prize for Literature. And to moderate this session, we have with us the very talented Dr. Shakti Sharma. Ma'am is a doctorate in food and nutrition and has qualified UGC NET. Ma'am has also received her master's degree with gold medal in food and nutrition from Rani Durgavati University, Jabalpur. She subsequently completed her internship from AIIMS, New Delhi and Jyotiram Hospital, Indore. Ma'am is an academician and holistic clinical nutritionist specializing in weight management and sports nutrition for young athletes. Ma'am also holds a teaching experience for over 12 years in reputed undergraduate and postgraduate institutes of Nagpur. Ma'am is a certified diabetic educator and is successfully running a diet clinic, Nutrition and You, since more than 5 years. An impressive public speaker in health and wellness, and regularly conducts awareness sessions for corporate, various government organizations and NGOs. Ma'am regularly contributes in print and digital media related to health and wellness. Her passion turned into profession and has profoundly contributed to the book for upcoming home scientists, nutritionists and food scientists. With this, I would now like to hand over the stage to you, ma'am. The session
Thank
is
all you.
Yours.
Thank you so much, Saurabh. Food and Indian tradition can never be separated. Indian tradition mein khana sirf khana ek activity nahi hai. It is our culture. Even if we look back to the Indus Valley civilization, when the humans were just gatherers of food and we hunted food for our villages, that time also we have a legacy of culture. The Harappan culture, when humans started to cultivate their food, there also the Indian culture has a beautiful legacy. Indeed, Indian culture has a flavorful legacy when it comes to cooking and food. Today, we are fortunate to have with us an author who has traveled the nation to learn about the different cuisines, and her travel has actually influenced her own food. I welcome Meeta Kapoor, ma'am, for today's session. Thank you so much, ma'am, and to be with us. So, ma'am, to begin with today's talk, my first question is, what does actually food means to you?
Thank you so much to everyone at the Orange City Literature Festival for inviting me to speak. It's indeed very nice to meet like-minded people and to know that we have live audiences here. To me, food is not just about sustenance, Shakti. It's also about flavor, texture. It's about living culture. For me, food is something that becomes a symbol or a metaphor for the culture of a place, a city, an area. Especially in our country, because we are innovating over years. And Indian cuisine has developed with a particular science behind it.
Yeah.
So, you know, and all of us know that, every recipe, there are ingredients there just to perform the function of flavor, but also to perform a particular responsibility that they bring along with their characteristics. So if there is an enlightenment or there is a long culmination about the recipe, they are there to not just to add flavor, but they also add something to the health of that dish. And so in that connection to the health of the person who's eating that dish. There are also stories, there is history. There's a lot of customs, traditions that are associated with our food. So in that sense, to me, many things. It's just not as simple as just going into the kitchen and cooking a simple mohi dal. It's much more than nutrition only.
Yeah, I truly agree to that, ma'am. When ma'am says ki whatever ingredients we put in our food, they have a therapeutic value also. Yeah. And even when we define food according to the WHO also, it is not only the emotional factor also comes in it, the spiritual factor also comes in it, because when a mother cooks a food for the child, she actually passes on her love in that food. So ma'am, what are your memories about food when you were a kid? And what motivated you to get into this, making it as a passion for you?
See, childhood for us was, for me especially, was a very happy time. My mother and my father both were confirmed foodies, so to say. It's just that they were both very busy professionals. So we grew up in a household where nutrition was always paramount, because my mother's a doctor and also top of that a good nutrition. So you can imagine how health conscious the family. Having said that, yes, she would always take her time to cook on the days she had, which was not that often because her profession kept her so busy. But I also grew up with an elder sister who was very, very fond of cooking. So I used to sit on the kitchen window and watch her cook. And that is that kind of time when the foundations for my attachment, finding out more about me. It wasn't just about the sex. I guess the foundation was laid then. And childhood memories of all sorts. We traveled on board. We always carried food with us whenever we were on road trips, because that was the system then.
And that used to be a special menu. We used to wait ki aloo ki sabzi and puri pack hogi.
And we went on picnics also. A lot of family trips were there. Apart from road trips, I think we also traveled abroad a lot. So one got exposed to all kinds of cuisines, and all kinds of experiences. And that was, I think, what really richly featured my life. And I never gave up on that part of the experiences that we gathered as children. I started cooking also at a very young age. I was just in college.
Okay.
Yeah, and my father was in a transferable job, and I was doing college from Delhi, so it was just me and my dad. So I used to really take a lot of interest in cooking and making sure that there's a lot of good food on the table. I experimented a lot. I love baking, so baking is a science on its own. So there was a lot of trial and error, lots of hours.
Yeah.
But one learns, with every trial and error, with every experiment, with every recipe that you try, you grow and you learn. But it was a good time. Simpler times, right? Simple times. For me, I think a picnic was as good as, like, we just went, because I live in Jaipur. If mom would just pack up a picnic lunch and we'd go to Statue Circle, which is right in the center of the city right now, and we would just spread our feet and run around. So for us, as children, I think we were simple in that sense. We didn't think of necessarily having to be 100 miles away, 50 miles away, or, you know, just on the outskirts of the city. We were happy in the center of the city. But it was a good time.
I think on reading a book, one would actually fall in love with eating. Because the way you decide and you describe the kebabs and about the salads and dips, you actually put the flavor into that. I could, being a vegetarian, was able to feel how a kebab would taste. And I really felt I should taste a kebab, how it melts into the mouth and it goes down. You're not supposed to chew a kebab. So, ma'am, you actually decided to study about the history of food, or it is that you studied and then you decided I should think more about it?
I didn't study anything at all, frankly.
Okay.
I just went from experience to experience. I just stumbled along organically. In fact, when I was writing the book also, I didn't really plan ki ye sab jayega meri kitab mein. As I kept traveling, I kept building up the book. So there was nothing that was like completely organized. If I was in Bombay, I roamed the streets of Bombay. If I was in Lucknow, I roamed the streets there. If I was in Delhi, I just went to eat somewhere. Or even if I was eating at a friend's place. So when we were traveling all over Europe, again, it was something very, very, it was, I think what you're saying is, it was, for me also, it was just like falling into the Alice in Wonderland kind of hole, you know. You're just falling into that hole and you're letting things happen to you.
Yeah.
And for me, it was just that. If I traveled to some place in Rajasthan and I discovered a particular flavor of a particular mirchi somewhere, or started talking to a local person and, you know, that person gave me a local recipe, I wrote it just the way they described it.
Right.
Credit goes more for people who gave so much to me while I was asking them. For me, it was just to capture it in a few words and put it on. Given to me, which I'm always thankful for. But and a lot of people gave it. That's why the book came together.
Ma'am, when we talk about the Indian cuisine, I think Lucknow also always wins over. मतलब लखनऊ की नजाकत है, लखनऊ का खाना है. तो मैम, आप हमें लखनऊ के कुजीन के बारे में कुछ बताइए. Which you think we don't know only, what is Lucknow cuisine?
I think that's a very difficult question, because लखनऊ में एक टाइप का कुजीन थोड़ी है. एक तो वो टिपिकल नवाबी, उनका जो अवधी कुजीन है वो है, पर लखनऊ में बहुत रिच वेजिटेरियन क्विजीन भी है. फिर देर आर जस्ट टू मेनी एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ लखनऊ फूड टू बी एबल टू डिस्कस इट जस्ट एज एन आंसर टू अ क्वेश्चन. मेरा एक्सपीरियंस जहाँ तक रहा था, मैं तो एक शादी में गई थी. शादी तो बहाना आई बैडली शोड माय फेस एट द वेडिंग एंड आई वाज जस्ट लाइक I got hold of all my cousins there and all my relatives, and I asked them to give me tips. कहाँ जाऊँ, कैसे करूँ, क्या करूँ. So from one the old city in Aminabad, उधर से फिर उधर, एक जगह कहीं बिरयानी चखी तो एक जगह कहीं कबाब चखे, एक जगह किसी से और कुछ बात करी, कुछ सवाल पूछे, और जो जो मुझे नगेट्स मिलते गए इंफॉर्मेशन के, मैं किताब में डालती गई. तो भी स्पीकिंग मैंने डीप रूटेड कोई स्टडी नहीं करी है. आई एम नॉट एकेडमिकली ओरिएंटेड एट ऑल. एंड कुछ कुछ हिस्ट्री के नगेट्स मिले, कुछ किताबें पढ़ी. तो उसमें जो अवधी क्विज़ीन है, जो नवाब के किचन में डेवलप हुआ था, वो बहुत ही ज़्यादा कुछ तो आई थिंक उन्होंने बहुत रिसर्च करके अपने क्विज़ीन की एक मोल्ड में ढाला है. बिकॉज जिस तरीके से मसाले घेर लेते हैं एक बेसिक रॉ मटेरियल को, वो हर एक अपना है. तो चाहे वो गलावट का कबाब हो, चाहे वो बिरयानी हो, चाहे वो कोई टाइप का कोरमा हो या कुछ भी हो, बिरयानी जैसे शेफ ने वहाँ पे बताया कि हम सिर्फ आम की लकड़ी के चूल्हे पे चढ़ाते हैं बिरयानी. So there was something that I didn't realize.
Yeah.
इतना फर्क पड़ेगा.
Right.
पर्टिकुलर किस्म का चावल होना चाहिए, वो इतने टाइम पर भूनना चाहिए. फिर आपने ये गर्म मसाले डालने हैं क्योंकि एक ये फ्लेवर बढ़ाता है, और अगर इस मसाले पर्टिकुलर चीज से बादी होती है तो ये चीज ये मसाला डाल रहा है जिससे वो फट जाए.
राइट.
जैसे आजकल हल्दी का इतना शोर हो रहा है. हल्दी तो हमारे कुजीन में इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन से, हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन से चलती आ रही है हल्दी. अभी उनके एक्सक्वेशन में भी कई रिपोर्ट मैंने पढ़ी है जो उनको सबसे पहले ट्रेसेस हल्दी की मिले.
राइट.
अब पूरे संसार में मच रहा है. हम लोग तो ही खाते पीते आए हैं. बट या आई डिडंट रियली गेट इन आई मीन आई रेड अ लॉट before I started writing my own work. But because I also wanted to focus down and sift out what I wanted to not write about and what I wanted to keep in mind. Because it was a journey of my family of what I could for them. You know, a lot of it was focused around what was finally made in my life.
Now, like when you were traveling, so what was one of your greatest experience about food? Means which actually changed your vision towards cooking. Was there some special experience?
So many special experiences. I think every city gave me a special experience, whether I was in Prague or I was in Budapest or I was in Frankfurt or I was in London or I was in the Shekhawati region in Rajasthan or I was in somewhere close to Udaipur or in Devgar. I think there are just too many memories. Hyderabad, 3 years pehle Hyderabad mein medical reasons se gayi thi, but udhar bhi kisi ko request kiya tha, so that person was taking us around. Aur jis tarike se humne Hyderabad dikhaya hai, ek sadak par, to har kone mein kuch naya milta tha. Khane ko experience karne ko, taste karne ko, unse sawal poochne ko. So I don't think there is just one food experience that really changed my thing. I was just naturally inclined towards cooking and naturally inclined towards. I was naturally just very very curious to find out. अगर ऐसे होता है तो क्यों ऐसे होता है? मैं अगर इसको ऐसे करेंगे तो क्या क्या हो जाएगा? और वो वैसे करने से तो हमेशा उल्टा पड़ा है.
Actually, while reading a book, I really came across that you always experiment with flavors, be it in dips or soups. But really, ma'am, how does your family respond to that? Means when you
something they like, something they don't like. So if I go very healthy in my recipes, then they all say, "ये शकल से ही बहुत healthy लग रहा है. ये जरूर किसी ने बनाया होगा."
Yeah.
सैलेड में लाइक माय किड्स विल टेल मी मम्मी ये सैलेड कुछ ज्यादा ही ग्रीन नहीं हो गया है क्या? यू नो यू कांट बट आई ऑलवेज ट्राइड गिविंग देम एक्सपेरिमेंटेड विद माय सैलेड. आई डेफिनेटली लॉट ऑफ ट्विस्ट ऑन अब कहीं से मेरे को चटनी नजर आ गई या कहीं मैंने टेस्ट किया वेल प्रोबब्ली पुट अ टीस्पून टू फ्रेंच ड्रेसिंग एंड से अच्छा मे बी लेट्स सी व्हाट इट लाइक इट डज लाइक द अदर डे आई मेड समथिंग एंड एवरीबॉडी नोज स्क्रूज अप देयर नोज समथिंग स्वीट एंड बिकॉज़ आई नो इट्स हेल्दी आई सेड लिसन आई हैव फ्लेवर्ड इट विद स्टफ and I put some mixed herbs in it, fresh basil. ये garden में उग रहा है वो fresh.
Right.
और burnt garlic के साथ भी अच्छा contrast है. So just to get them eat that pumpkin soup, what I did was I took a melon scooper and I scooped out छोटा-छोटा balls of goat cheese and I just swirled the goat cheese
okay.
pumpkin soup and I presented it to my husband and said, "तो क्यों लोगे ना?"
Right.
It looks very interesting. Just because you could see कि कुछ cheese type चीज़ है वहाँ पे. And he loved it because yeah. you know, the flavors came together somehow. So a simple things like that. And you know, you don't have to be complicated with your ingredients. You have to stand in front of your cupboard. क्या सॉस है, क्या सब्जी है, क्या है जो आप करा, जैसे अभी सीजन में गांठ गोभी है, हिंग जीरे में सब्जी भी छोड़ते हैं और गांठ गोभी को हम लंबा लंबा जूलियंस में काट के उसमें थोड़ा सा लेमन ग्रास और थोड़ा सा काफी लाइम लीव्स और थोड़ा सा स्वीट चिली सॉस अगर बना देंगे तो वो थाई सैलेड बन जाता है, बहुत टेस्टी.
Yeah, that is so in your book, ma'am. You have actually made a variety of salads also. But because it was a challenge to you, you have created so many salads. But ma'am, I just ask one question. You have so many recipes of kebabs and non-veg. Which is your favorite?
From the book, you have favorites, frankly.
Yeah.
I love the galauti kebab, which I learned in Lucknow. Jiski recipe maine dali bhi hai. There's a Surajmukhi kebab that really is very nice. Because wo Surajmukhi kebab ko hamara ek hotel hai Delhi Jaipur highway pe Alila Fort Krishna. Unke menu mein bhi maine kafi recipes apne try kari bhi dali hain.
Okay.
Surajmukhi kebab bhi bahut popular ho gaya hai hamare guests ke sath. Ek Kashmiri style kebab banta hai, rishta banta hai. तो वो रिश्ता मेरी मदर इन लॉ से सीखा था. फिर आई हैव वेरी क्लोज कश्मीरी फ्रेंड्स, उनके यहाँ भी चुप कर देन आई केम अप विद माय ओन वर्जन ऑफ इट. बट दीज आर फ्यू थिंग्स दैट आर ऑलवेज
ओके. मैम, मूविंग टू योर बुक, इन योर बुक यू हैव आल्सो एम्फसाइज्ड दैट फूड इज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द मूड. मैम, व्हाट इज योर से ऑन दिस?
देखिए, दोनों तरीके से काम होता है ये फूड. आपका जिस दिन मूड ठीक नहीं है, आप कुछ भी कर लोगे, आपका खाना उस दिन अच्छा नहीं लगेगा.
राइट.
यू नो, इफ यू आर फोर्सिंग योरसेल्फ टू, एंड इट्स समथिंग दैट इज यूनिवर्सल, इफ यू आर फोर्सिंग योरसेल्फ टू डू समथिंग, यू नो, इट्स नेवर गोइंग टू हैव दैट परफेक्ट, दैट परफेक्शन दैट यू वांट. ऑन द अदर हैंड, इफ यू आर रियली फीलिंग लो एंड आउट, or you're really tired, at least this I've done it for myself. In the middle of a working day, I've just walked into the kitchen and I baked a cake and it's come out for me and I've shared it with everyone in my home, and you know, immediately the spirit. So it works.
It yeah
pata chal jata. There are times when I put something on the dinner table and my family looks at it and says, आज तो मतलब आप किसी से नाराज थे या कुछ तो बात हुई होगी.
ओके.
एंड आई एम डेफिनेटली, आई एम ऑलवेज ऑनेस्ट टू एडमिट, एंड आई इनफैक्ट नाउ आई हैव स्टार्टेड टेलिंग देम बिफोर हैंड ओनली, बट देयर आर नो गारंटीज टुडे गाइस, आई डोंट नो हाउ इट्स गोइंग. सो दैट इमीडिएटली नो दैट शी नोज ऑलरेडी कि कुछ गड़बड़ है.
राइट.
यू नो, व्हाइल यू आर कुकिंग एंड यू आर रीचिंग द फाइनल स्टेज, यू रियलाइज इट योरसेल्फ कि यस, यू हैव गॉन रॉन्ग समवेयर. So that means you haven't put your 100% into it.
Yes, okay.
So if you don't put your 100% into anything, it's never going to be right. That perfect thing that you want to achieve. So it applies to food, it applies to anything in life.
It absolutely. Right. Right. Ma'am, there's another question related to your book only, ma'am. Even the religion affects the food. It has a strong influence on the food we eat. So through this journey, what was your experience of in religion affecting the food?
See, when we were growing up, my father and mother used to keep a fast on Tuesday because they were both Hanuman Bhakts.
Okay.
And so they would eat vegetarian food on Tuesday. And till a certain stage, you know, all three of our sisters were fine with it. When we started, you know, थोड़ी सी जब अक्कल आने लगती है, you start asserting yourself. Then we started questioning our parents, and they said, you know what, guys, you guys go ahead and do what you want. This is our belief. We are not supposed to know you.
Right.
That's the kind of environment I grew up in. You know, so religion was never something that we could trust on us as far as food practices were concerned. अब जन्माष्टमी है, आई वुड सी, इन स्पाइट ऑफ बीइंग अ वेरी बिजी, माय My mother used to do the whole paraphernalia of her type of prasad banta tha, her type of kheer banti thi, jo bhi Janmashtami ka, similarly Diwali ka khana, sare pakwan bante the. She would actually sit and make the gujia and the besan wali papri and what else was there? Beech ki barfi. Yeah, beech ki barfi. Confused now. But you know, khaskhas ka halwa banta.
Yes, ma'am.
दिवाली के लंच के लिए जिमिकंद होता था हमेशा. जिमिकंद की सब्जी करी करी हमेशा बनती थी. मूली बैंगन की सब्जी. सो वी ऑल्सो आई मीन यू नो व्हेन वी ग्रो वी केप गोइंग एंड वी बिकेम सो द फ्लेवर्स वी ऑल्सो इन टर्न स्टार्टेड डिस्कवरिंग दैट एटलीस्ट त्योहारों वाले जो त्योहार कोई खाएंगे वो एंजॉय करें. वी एक्चुअली स्टार्टेड लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू इट. इट्स जस्ट थ्रस्ट ऑन अस. You know, we were given the choice to do what.
Absolutely. When, I mean, you traveled, yeah.
When I got married and came here, my in-laws were from the army, so they traveled from city to city, so they never really stuck to any religious practices. Frankly, there was nothing that was done as such for and no fast. I came from a house where Gyaras ka bhi fast hota tha, Poonam ka bhi fast, Purnima ka bhi fast hota tha. Sheetla Mata ko pura hum log observe karte the. It was the Sharad Purnima ka bhi fast hota tha.
Right.
We still keep on the kheer outside.
Banti
thi jiske through wo dekhti thi chand ko and you know puja karte thi. Phir she would come in and serve all of us food. So sab hum padhe hue hain dekho but yahan aakar kuch bhi nahi kar sakte. So it was all marzi hai. Diwali ke din meet bakayda meet karta hamare ghar.
Right.
I'm the one who makes.
Okay.
So then there's absolutely so, and we are a large joint family, so we are like all of us are free to do what we want. So while 2-3 people in the joint family don't have to do much, we can then actually fast. Now I've got so used to not fasting and not doing anything, so maybe to plan to get that to do that. So chalo, you know, veg khalo. Ab wo just chalo chalo.
So I mean, you're traveling also. You saw this that the cultures influence the food choices. Different cultures, different places.
Absolutely. Because see, my mother-in-law traveled through the country because of the army postings, and she herself is a fantastic. I've learned a lot. So she also gathered recipes from all the states. So we literally have. Like she has these old handwritten registers of recipes.
Okay.
Which
wow.
I actually got photostated because wo itne buri halat mein ho gaye the because we also went to them and we also tried so many dishes and everything. So we actually inculcated the culture of the states because of that. Because of her experiences and she gathered recipes and she kind of encouraged us to try them more. Just because she saw so and baking and everything. So yeah, I mean we've talked about everything and anything in this game. There's no limit at all.
And
then influence karte hai. Younger generation hai to unko pizza hi khana hai ya pasta hi khana hai ya wo log fir wo experiment karte hain khud banate hain ghar mein. खुद ट्राई करते हैं पिज्जा को बनाना पूरी थाई थाई और चाइनीज जो भी बनाना था सब बनता है सब कुछ बनता है. सो यू नो इट्स लाइक द वर्ल्ड
या आई थिंक द वर्ल्ड इज लर्निंग कुकिंग फ्रॉम इंडिया बिकॉज एज वी से द अमाउंट ऑफ फ्लेवर्स इंडियन कुजीन यूजेस दैट इज समथिंग न्यू फॉर देम. एज मैम सेड कि हल्दी का यूज हम बहुत पहले से कर रहे हैं एंड व्हेन इवन व्हेन कोविड केम ironically it was said ki we don't need to add any more haldi in our diet, we don't need kada with haldi, we already have the optimum amount of haldi in our diet. So that's a great legacy that we are carrying with us.
Absolutely.
What brought you into writing? How did you thought of writing a book and that too with such a quickie title?
See, I was always very fond of writing as a child. I continued writing through my school times. I continued writing through college. I trained as a journalist. So I was writing features, articles, all sorts of things, researching very heavily. And food is something that I'm very passionate about. I love feeding people. I may not eat that much myself, but I love feeding people and experimenting. So it was just a very natural progression for all of these. I just landed up writing a book. Also because I can't write fiction to save my life.
Okay.
Just can't. I'm too trained to be a long-form non-fiction narrative writer because of my journalistic training. And I'm very trained to research and read and then put things together. So, yeah, I think that also just led me to it. Because before writing a book, I was actually working very actively as a journalist.
Okay.
And I covered a lot of focus areas. So, you know, your mind got trained to researching on all sorts of things. Mm-hmm. And, you know, feeling close to them. I always picked up on issues that I felt close to, that I knew that I could just put myself entirely into that particular thing that I'm writing about. So food just happened. Also, I really enjoy
it.
I love experimenting and I love tasting new things.
And I would also like to know the premise of your yet another very quick book that is on the Chilies and Porridges. So what is that book all about?
See, Chilies and Porridges, Chilies and Porridge was actually, it's a food anthology where I reached out to a lot of food writers and or maybe they were not even food writers, but I realized that they had stories to tell. The food is very, very close to nostalgia, with memory, with food tradition in different regions. There are 2-3 food anthologies in India. One came out with Oxford University Press. One was done by Nilanjana Roy. A couple of other anthologies. And it was just that me and my editor, then we were just talking and we said, you know what, there's not enough writing happening in India. So the idea of the anthology is born, and then I just put the concept together and I reached out to the contributors that you see have written such fantastic stories in the anthology, and that's how the anthology came around. So we covered a lot of topics in the interviews and forage. And a lot of people still go back to reading that anthology because of the wide range of areas that it covers. Like there's a chapter in Malwa, then there's a chapter in the interview that talks about his memories and past memories, and chapter by Floyd Carlos, who was first year, very sadly to go to New York. There are a lot more people who contributed. Nilanjana contributed another chapter. I mean, there's so many Tara Deshpande. So you see, you get different perspectives on food. You get their values, their culture into one. You know? So that was the idea of Tourism for it.
And it has come up amazing. It's a read everyone's authored book, like I would say. Ma'am, but if young authors are coming up and they want to write book, so how could you give them a message ki, how should they go about writing a book? Because a number of books are actually conceptualized, they are written also, but never printed. It's a difficult task to get a book printed also.
The first thing I'd say is please read a lot. Just read a lot before you start writing. And before you start writing, make sure you're aware of the language you want to write in. Do you want to write in your mother tongue? Do you want to write in an adopted language? That's very, because your comfort, your honesty, your transparency as a writer will show in the language that you think in, that you imagine in. And if it is a bit of research, then please do your research before you start writing. So, you know, the point that you start reading with the aim of writing a book that you have in mind. So when you start reading and then you start researching and then you identify what you want to write, you would have grown as a person. Your own evolution would have taken place, and that will reflect in the writing. So if you write in the language you imagine and think it, that will be the best way to do it.
Absolutely. It's a great advice, ma'am. And it was great talking to you today, ma'am. And hope to see you again some other time in this festivity. Thank you so much.
And thank you for making the effort to go through both the books. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Most welcome. I now hand over the session to the Saurabh, our anchor for the day.
Thank you so much, Meeta ma'am, for sharing such a wonderful tips about food, the tradition, and the culture related to food. I hope our foodie viewers might have enjoyed the session a lot. And a thanks to our moderator, Shakti ma'am, for handing over and to moderating the session with such a grace. Thank you so much, ma'am. On behalf of Orange City Literature Fest, we sincerely express our gratitude towards your acceptance for becoming the speaker and the moderator of this session, and also for the wonderful knowledge you have shared with us. Thank you to our viewers for watching this session. The next session will be by Arun Myra on leading, learning, and listening in conversation with Shabbir Shakir. Till then, keep watching Orange City Literature Fest. Thank you.
Twenty years of existence. Two universities. 23 educational institutes. Offering 137 courses. Thy Sony Group of Institutions. A vision beyond.